Book of Acts chapter 6. Book of Acts chapter 6. Two things I missed it, but I had them on my notes. Two things I missed it. The man of God was with us last night and this morning. He's visiting from India first time, and he is the overseer of the region, Kerala State. Pastor Joseph, T. Sam, could you please stand up for 1 second? Respecting him, welcome. Number two is in Kollam, southern part of India. This morning, there was a fireworks in one of the temple. 107 people got killed in that fireworks, and 200 people in the hospital. It is from Kollam area. They said one of the temple got fired and got the fireworks, and there's still things are going on. Please remember those people in your prayers this morning. You just heard about the message of the calling of God. The passage he read the second time is the life of Stephen. The life of Stephen, when he stood up and said, and the people looked at him, everyone looked at him and throw stones at him, and he gave his life to God, and he committed his life to him. That did not start like that in the beginning. Every calling has a beginning. If you look at the chapter 6 of book of Acts, it says like this: in those days, the first 6 verses, I believe, 1 through 6, in those days when the numbers of disciples were increasing, the Hellenistic Jew among them complained against the Hellenistic Hebrew Jews because of their widows were being overlooked in the daily distribution of food. Every time when there is a growth, there will be challenges. Every time when you want to go to a next level in your life, there will be challenges. They were having church at that time. They were having few numbers. Eventually, the Hellenistic or Hebrew and non-Hebrew people started to come. First generation and the second generation started to come. And when they came, any time, people of God, in your life also, in your workplace, in your job, in your career, in your education, any time when there is a next level of growth, there will be challenges. There was a problem in that group. In that group has a problem, discrimination. And you just heard about discrimination. And people unknowingly discriminate. Simply, those two groups, same Jewish people, but the difference was that there are Jewish people, original Hebrew, and also people who born under the system speaking Greek as their first language. Even though they are Greek, Jewish people, they were speaking Greek language. That was a problem. So those two groups started to minister together in the church. The widows came and they started to serve. And in that serve, in that ministry, there were discrimination took place. But at that middle of the problem, the leaders gathered together and they said, we are not going, we're going to solve the problem. People of God, any time, remember this, when there is a problem comes in your life, there is a calling coming to you.
Hallelujah.
If there is a crisis in your workplace, and if your boss got fired, and that means they are looking for someone, they need somebody. In your home, in your situation, in your career, or in your spiritual walk, when there is a need, you group. I use an example. Women's ministry, I use an example. Evangelism area, I use an example. Anytime when there is a void or a need that comes there, that means a calling coming right there.
Hallelujah.
Stephen was there. He was not part of it. He was doing something. If you study that passage, it's clear that we can understand all the people who were selected in the group were Hellenistic or Greek speaking Jewish people. If there is anyone who listened to me this morning, if you are going through any crisis in your job, in your career, in your spiritual walk, in your relationship, that means the reason it came to you and you are present there, that means there is a calling for you to solve that problem.
Hallelujah.
If there is an issue in your home, and if you are a prayer warrior, and if you know that bothering you, that means God is dealing with you, and there is a calling upon your life to solve that problem through you.
Hallelujah.
Are you with me?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. You are not a spectator. You are not just a living being to breathe and to die. There is a purpose in your life. There is an eternal destiny and eternal purpose God called you to. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Every time in my life, I'm sure if I give you the microphone, all of you can testify sometime. There was a crisis took place and you were present and God selected you for that job.
Hallelujah.
But you need to be ready. You need to be ready. How they were not selected. They were serving. They were serving and there was a need. I faced that all the time in my life in the ministry. There was challenges after challenges came. Even today you heard, I was so happy when he sent me the outline. The selection is subject itself is to a selection or calling. You are chosen. When there is a need in your life, when there's a need in the community, this America is in a crisis. America is in a crossroad. Believe it or not. Trust me, people of God, this nation, our nation, which built under or with the foundation, are stood by Jesus Christ and the kingdom of God.
Hallelujah.
It is in a crisis moment that this year, next year, years to come, we are in a crossroad. This nation in a desperate need. The reason you are getting now born last 100 years ago. The reason you did not born 50 years ago. The reason you are here today breathing because you are the one God is looking to call.
Hallelujah.
To fulfill the destiny.
Hallelujah.
Which God called you to.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You did not walk into the sanctuary accidentally. It is God who brought you here to make you to listen to this. To remind you, God called you for a reason.
Hallelujah.
There was a crisis. Crisis is not a bad thing. Crisis is not a bad thing.
Hallelujah.
Many times people think crisis is a bad thing. Crisis is not a bad thing. Because without crisis, you never know who you are.
Hallelujah.
Without a problem, no one will know who you are. Goliath came and stood there fighting and challenging. David came. No one knew. That morning, David was walking. That morning, Daddy calling, "Daddy, take this cheesecake to your brothers." Simply that was the assignment. Young boy, young lad, taking care of the sheep. No one knew him. There was an anointing upon his life, and God called him when he was away and in front of the family. He got the anointing.
Hallelujah.
No one knew about him.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. But that morning, when he was going to the field, Goliath, the big guy, standing there challenging the people of God. He was making fun of Jehovah, God, and no one cared about it. My dear beloved, let me ask you, if someone spit in the name of Jesus, someone cursed the name of Jesus, does that bother you in your classroom?
Hallelujah.
In your society, in your schools and colleges, when this liberal media making fun of Jesus Christ, does it burn you?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. David was going and walking through there, and Goliath was standing 40 days touch them. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
David did not say, I came to drop the cheesecake, let me go back. He said, who is this guy standing and making fun of my God?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He was not a soldier. He did not have a gun with him. He did not have anything. And he looked, I have nothing. Only thing I could, he could find you 5 stones.
Hallelujah.
But I truly believe that day, Goliath did not come there for anything else. There was a calling upon David's life. It needed to be known to the king. There is a calling upon David's life. That calling needs to be known to the city of Hallelujah, Jerusalem and the cities.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. If there is any problem coming to your life, people of God, remember this. If you are present today, you are the answer.
Hallelujah.
Stephen serving the food. There was a problem. But the Bible says they selected him. He could easily walk away. How you respond to your calling. How you respond to your calling. Stephen could easily say, I don't want to do this. What? Serving food? Serving food is not my calling. Preaching is my calling. Stephen is a preacher. But the assignment was to serve food. When you are faithfully fulfilling what God assigned you, the assignment of your life, I believe it was Tony Evans used this example. He was working when he was young. Pastor Tony Evans, when he was young, he was working in a night shift in a warehouse. In the warehouse, there was a problem. Just like most of you do, the ice sand in my years ago in workplace. What happened was they were punching the clock, other person's car. Twinset. What happened is at night, they go for break. They escape. They go from the workplace. Somebody else punched them in. So at night, everyone was cheated. Nobody was working well. It went on for some time. The only one problem, this young man, Tony Evans, he was a born-again Christian, grew up in a good Christian family. He did not want to change that. He said, I'm going to punch a card myself. And he stayed there. He worked all night, he stayed there. He was the only one out of there. And there was a job assignment came. They were looking for a supervisor for the night shift. Everyone said, he's the other person going to get. He is more experienced. Mm-hmm. Finally, they called Tony Evans to the office. He said, Tony, we're going to assign you or giving you this promotion. He was a junior person there. I don't care why. There are plenty of experienced people there. I cannot handle them. And they said, this is what they said. We were watching you guys for the last 6 months. Out of the whole group in that night shift, you are the only one faithful. We knew they were punching the clock for the person. We knew they were not working. We were monitoring all this time. We found out you are the only eligible person to get that job.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Stephen was called to serve on the table. The calling is later, chapter 7, you see, he only preached one message. Look at that. If you go to any seminary, that is what the message they used to teach, the strength structure of a message. Anyone who went to a seminary, this is the passage they used to teach how to preach. This was his calling. He knew how to preach. But the problem is, that was not the assignment. When you are faithful to the assignment God is giving you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. No one might know.
Hallelujah.
No one will know. Many other things and activities take place in this church. You come here, no one knows what happens. You see a nice place, everything is cleaned up, everything going wonderful. You don't know there is two or three people come early morning, 9 in the morning, they pray there downstairs. You don't know who comes here 7:30 in the morning and sitting in the sanctuary and praying and practicing.
Hallelujah.
Many of you have no idea. But I wanted to tell you, people of God, in your workplace also, in your secular job, be faithful to God, because you are a child of God. There's a calling upon you.
Hallelujah.
There is somebody watching you in your life. There's a right time. Bible says he was ministering there and he served the food, but the time came. Somebody need to stand for Jesus Christ. Stephen said, I'm going to stand up.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. He only preached one message, one preaching. You don't need to preach 1,000 messages, you only need one preaching if that is what your destiny is. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He preached one message, the Bible says, at the end of that he died. But do you know that message is still preaching? Even today, Stephen is preaching, and I'm mentioning his name.
Hallelujah.
There are many other people who serve the food there. Their name is not mentioned. Hallelujah. Hannah has many children. Hallelujah. Hannah has only had one Samuel after a long time. Penina had many children at that time. Nobody mentioned Penina anymore.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
My dear beloved, what I want to tell you this morning, the calling is there. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. The calling is there. Calling happens most of the time during the trials or a crisis. Christ, if there is any crisis you to face, that means God wants to take you a greater level in calling.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Remember this, you are a child of God. God has a purpose for you. Jesus did not die on the cross and save you for nothing. He saw you. Just like you heard this morning, he looked at your heart. He did not look at your face. He did not look at your appearance. The appearance will change. Face can change. Hair can change. But the heart cannot do it. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Give me 5 minutes, I can change your color. Any shape you want, you can change. But give it 1,000 years, I cannot change your heart.
Hallelujah.
God knows your heart.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jesus, look at your heart this morning. Are you faithful to God? Hallelujah. Is your love to Jesus Christ real? Are you serving to God, serving the Lord? Any capacity, you might be a Sunday school teacher, you might be a cell group leader, you might be doing many things, or you might be doing a simple thing. Nobody appreciate the young man sitting in the back doing all these things. Yeah. Nobody appreciate. I don't think you ever tell him, Renchi, you're doing a wonderful job. I don't think. That's normal. Because that's the way it is. Think about it. If there's a crisis, that's when a very rich man. If there's a light out, if there's one television doesn't work, very rich man. At the time of crisis, then you will know who you are.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Do not run away from troubles. Do not run away from challenges in your life. If there is a crisis, that means that God placed you there for a reason. You are the answer God is looking. Stephen was the answer for the solution of the problem of the church at that time. There was discrimination in that group, and God changed it for the glory of God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This morning, hallelujah. How you react to the crisis will determine your destiny. Even though you have a calling, sometimes you will not respond to the calling. Even though there is a destiny in your life, sometimes you will never respond. If you don't respond to the calling, God cannot use you. Bible clearly you see that. You see the selection in the Bible from the beginning to the end. You will see that calling is there. One person got it, next person missed it. Hallelujah. In Icing as a pastor here, there are many people who receive the word of the wisdom, the word of the prophetical words, and many people miss it. Some people get it. Why? You respond to it.
Hallelujah.
Bible clearly says that if somebody prophesies something to me, I write it on my book. I prepare myself. If God tells me you're going to travel to our world, I better go and buy it. Hallelujah. I get that, renew my passport.
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. If God is sending you, God is giving you, God is going to give you a prosperity in some area, you need to be ready for it. How God is going to prepare? God is giving you. You say, I believe in the Lord. I believe. No, you did not even apply for a passport.
Hallelujah.
You need to be ready to receive the blessing of God. You, the assignment God wants to give you, you need to be ready for it.
Hallelujah.
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 David was ready. In that valley, he said, I have nothing. I don't look like them. I don't have the weapon they have. But one thing I know how to throw.
Hallelujah.
When he looked at that big giant, everyone said, you're going to miss it. How can I miss that big one? How can you fail? You are a child of God. If you are faithful in the presence of God in your workplace, I wanted to tell you, you will never fail.
Hallelujah.
I work in East New York. I work in the toughest area of Brooklyn. Many years. East New York was not the easiest place. I have my workers, I remember, called me from first-hand people or new people. Here, we found a gun in this mailbox. We found a bunch of drugs. I said, there. Just control it with your men and go. We know it is there.
Yeah.
That place, challenges of the challenges came, but God placed me there for victory.
Hallelujah.
If God placed you anywhere and you have a calling in your life, you will never fail.
Hallelujah.
Jesus never failed. The child of Jesus Christ never failed.
Hallelujah.
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 If you are a child of God, if you are a daughter of God, you will never fail.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. God did not call you to fail, people of God, because there is a calling upon your life. Hallelujah. That morning, the calling came to Stephen's life, and he succeeded. And one preaching he did, that's all.
Hallelujah.
You don't need to live 1,000 years to fulfill your destiny, if that is what. But today is the day God has made, and it is your life, and you need to be victorious. Today is the day God's anointing upon you to fulfill what God called you for today. Tomorrow belongs to God. If tomorrow is my day, God will give me anointing to face the challenge I'm facing my life tomorrow. Today is the day you need to live for God. Tomorrow, let God worry about it. If I go tomorrow, if that is what I need. Hallelujah. There was a 5 stones in the valley came for years ago.
Yes.
The stones did not happen like that day. The stones has a story. The stone was destined by God. I cannot miss that big guy. Hallelujah. It was in the valley. It caught the eye of David. There are many other stones there at that time. But he looked at that stone that day. He picked it up. That stone has a story. I went through many years. Came through the water. Came through the ocean. I went through many, many years. Went through the process. All my tough area. It is so smooth now. Hallelujah. The character of the stone may change. Why he picked that stone? Because it was smooth. God cannot use your rough life. God wanted to prune you, make you soft. Hallelujah. It can be hard, it's fine, but you need to be soft. Hallelujah. If somebody touch you, does it itch them? Or somebody can come to your life, are you smooth? Hallelujah. You all work in a corporate in America. Who God people promote? If you don't get along with anybody in your office, can they promote you? No.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Your character need to change. The roughness need to change. You need to become smooth.
Hallelujah.
Jesus had no problem putting up with Judas, the one who betrayed him. Brother, friend, my friend. He called Judas my friend because Jesus knew his destiny. Do you know your destiny today? Jesus loves you. The reason you came here today to remind you, Jesus died for your sin. He is the only Savior. He is the only way to heaven. He is the only way to heaven. He is the only way to eternal life. If you believe Jesus Christ as your Savior, Jesus can save you even today. Whatever background you are, whatever situation you are, to remind you this morning, there is a destiny in your life. Jesus died for your sin. And He still saves people because He is the eternal God. Would you stand with me this morning? Father, we thank you and we praise you for this blessed time in our life. You called us for a destiny. You called us for a purpose. You reminded us again and again, over and over again, to remind us and tell us and to give us a surety. Your calling is real and it is for eternal. We thank you, God. We are able to walk into the sanctuary, spend time in your presence, enjoy your awesome worship time, hallelujah, to experience your deliverance in every area in our life, oh God. And I pray for everyone who are watching us, and even the people who are standing outside the other room also listening to us, oh God. We pray this morning, oh Lord, let your power deliver each one of us. Remind us and give us the surety that you are holding your hand, oh God. You called us. Because you called us, we know you will take us to the destiny you determined and you planned in our life, oh God. We love you, Jesus. And I thank you, God, for the victory given to our life this morning. We love you. Give you glory and worship. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Triumph God's blessings so be with us, each one of you, until the coming of the Lord. Put your hand together and give glory to God. Lord, He is alive. He is victorious. Jesus is coming quickly. God bless you all.